new security roles are now in place tonight at Pitt. New evidence today that the rash of bomb threats is affecting more than just the students and staff in Oakland. Channel 4 Action News reporter Marcy Cipriani is live tonight with more on this situation. What have you learned, Marcy?
Well, Janelle, this is certainly frustrating to Pitt students and staff. These bomb threats again today, several of them, but this time they affected some of the most vulnerable.
Weak, in pain, and in need of care, the Pitt bomb threats have now impacted the sick. Patients that should be resting here inside the university club were forced out as the bomb squad went in.
I had just gone back to our room when the alarm went off.
Kathy Yarnish is staying at the family house on Pitt's campus to be near a sick loved one. She is not from Pittsburgh, but has heard about the constant bomb threats, never imagining they would be next.
It was sad to see all the other patients here having to be taken out, and some on oxygen and some with big cases of medication.
While the patients were taken to another facility and police were here, four more threats were made on campus. None turned out credible, but all added to the campus frustration, University Club in particular.
That's the disturbing part, because those patients are transplant patients. They're very sick.
Pitt Police Chief Timothy Delaney says that has angered him most so far. For weeks now, his department has fought hard to catch the culprit. And now, after dozens of threats, they have made a list of changes, including adjusting the way they handle the all clear.
Right now, we're checking packages. We're checking book packs, backpacks. We want the individuals to have as much access as they can.
But despite the changes and the manpower, Pitt students and staff are finding it common to come outside and wait. This time, though, the sick were forced out, too. And while the threats seem to be growing, the leads are not.
To think that the actions of one or two could be so disruptive to so many people.
It took a little longer to clear the university club. In fact, the patients there had to be evacuated for several hours because a canine hit on something suspicious. A source tells me once the bomb squad was called in, they realized that it was actually dye packs from money rolls inside the money roll there, so in the money room there, excuse me. So that has been cleared. No bomb threats at this hour on Pitt's campus. For now, reporting live, Marcy Cipriani, Channel 4 Action News.